afternoon, welcome to City Hall Superior Service. Before we begin, we're going to take a moment and turn off the music. Our opening song is number 389, the advent of our town. Please stand and watch.
Thank you. read from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Paul, a slave of Christ Jesus, called to be an apostle and set apart for the gospel of God, which he promised previously through his prophets in the Holy Scriptures, the gospel about his Son, descended from David according to the flesh, but established as Son of God in power according to the Spirit of holiness, through resurrection from the dead, Jesus Christ our Lord. Through him we have received the grace of apostleship, to bring about the obedience of faith, for the sake of his name, among all the Gentiles, among whom are you also, who are called and belong to Jesus Christ, to all the beloved of God in Rome, called to be holy. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
Yeah.
number of choices and could not see which one was the best. He was receiving advice from many different advisors, the most important of which was the prophet Isaiah. Isaiah was encouraging the young king to be confident, to trust in God completely, and then act boldly. It is in this context that God says through Isaiah to Ahaz, "Ask me for a sign, and don't dream small. Dream big. Let it be deep as the netherworld or high as the sky." In other words, dream big. Trust much. Break out of the depressive little space of your own fears. And ask the Lord. But little frightened Ahaz says, "I will not ask. I will not tempt the Lord." Now, you as the reader just want to yell out at Ahaz, "What do you mean I won't tempt the Lord? He just invited you to dream big." But he won't. God's response to Ahaz shows that God was weary or frustrated by Ahaz's lack of imagination, by his inability to dream big in accord with God's designs. And so God says, "You're not going to dream big? Then I'm going to dream for you. I'm going to tell you what signs to look for." And then comes that wonderful prophecy of the birth of a child, Emmanuel, a Hebrew phrase which means God with us. A virgin will give birth to this child, and in that child, my own presence will come among you. I would like to submit that all of us, deep down, are Ahaz at some times in our lives. I don't care who you are in society or how successful you are. Deep down, all of us feel kind of small, beleaguered, confused, afraid, surrounded by forces more powerful than ourselves, wondering what we should do. And the Lord keeps saying to us, "Trust me. Dream big. Look for the signs among you that I am active." The child that was promised is in fact born and works among you now. Put your trust in him. In the case of Ahaz, his decision to ignore God's command cost him and his kingdom much. He decided to form an allegiance with the Assyrian Empire by sending emissaries to their leader, Tiglath-Pileser, with a small fortune in gold and asking the Assyrians to protect his kingdom from the oppressors, which is what happened. However, Ahaz had paid the Assyrians much more over time, and he then fell into what amounted to worship of the Assyrian gods, even to the point of building a new altar in the temple in Jerusalem, styled after the Assyrian pagan sacrifices. You can just imagine how his priests felt about that. Ahaz turned out to be one of the worst kings that Judah ever had, leaving a real mess to clean up for his son Hezekiah, a much better, more faithful king. People who read the Old Testament over the centuries have come to view Ahaz kind of like you're supposed to treat the villain when he walks out on the stage at the melodrama, right? You're supposed to boo. You're supposed to throw peanuts at him. That's how we feel about Ahaz, because he was such a rotten character. Now, flash forward about 750 years to a distant descendant of Ahaz, another son of the house of David, to Joseph. Like his ancestor, Joseph finds himself caught between some powerful forces. He's already betrothed to Mary, but they haven't lived together as husband and wife yet. And Joseph receives what must have been devastating news. His fiancée is pregnant, he knows he's not the father. This must have turned Joseph's world upside down. First of all, on a personal level, he was deeply hurt and humiliated. I mean, what man wouldn't be? And further, his plans to marry his beloved, his plans for his wife are falling down around him. And the woman he loved and thought he knew was suddenly like a stranger to him. How could she have betrayed him so blatantly? Well, these are the kinds of thoughts that must have been going through Joseph's mind when Mary told him that she was pregnant. But worst of all, Mary wouldn't be subject to the most dire penalties of the Jewish law. If word got out, she could be stoned to death according to the law of Moses. And so Joseph decides to end the relationship quietly. The English anyway says divorce, but it's actually not quite that strong. And perhaps he's even going to send her away for a while so that she would not have to suffer the fate of being stoned. Well, this was the terrible state of his soul when one night he fell asleep. Joseph, son of David, have no fear about taking Mary as your wife. It is by the Holy Spirit that she has conceived this child. Joseph, in his anxiety and despair, is being given a sign, a dream, beyond his wildest dreams, something he could never have imagined possible. God was showing him an impossibly glorious way out of this dilemma. So, ask God for a sign. Dream big. Remain open to the wild possibility that God holds out to you. In Joseph's case, God expands his mind, blows open his sense of the possible, and reveals God's great plan for him. We see at the end of the passage that St. Matthew saw the connection between Ahaz and Joseph when Matthew says, "All this happened to fulfill what the Lord had said to the prophet. The virgin shall be with child and give birth to a son, and they shall call him Emmanuel." Matthew saw this beautiful correspondence between the sign that Ahaz was invited to ask for, but refused, and the sign that was revealed to Joseph, which he believed and acted upon. That child promised to Ahaz now arrives in the time of Joseph. What do we learn from this? Well, one thing for sure, whatever trouble you're in, political, psychological, spiritual, social, wherever it may be, and we've all got problems, we're all hemmed in some way. What's God saying to us? Dream big. Allow your fantasy to run wild. It will fall short of what God wants to show you in giving. Because what he wants to give all of us is Jesus, Emmanuel. If we make him the center of our lives, he will begin to use us in ways that we can't even fathom. The virgin shall be with child, and this child shall be called Emmanuel. God is with us. Dream big and trust God. Let us stand out together and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father of all, the creator of the earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Thank you. For the church, as we proclaim that God is with us forever and always, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That all nations may coexist in lasting peace, and that attitudes of hatred and vengeance may become overwhelmed by love and mercy, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who find difficulty to celebrate at this time of year because of loneliness, conflict, loss, or other hardships, that they may find comfort in God's abiding presence, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our Jewish sisters and brothers as they celebrate Hanukkah, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the kindness and generosity we show at Christmas may take root and remain active in us throughout the year, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That God will show His mercy and keep our three little girls all of Cecilia and Woody happy throughout the holidays and thereafter. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That our sons and daughters serving in the military and police forces will be safe during this blessed season of the year. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the petitions in our basket will be answered. Prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, for all our intentions spoken and pronounced. Let us pray to the
Lord.
Loving God, you created the human race in your likeness, and sent your Son to be with us, fully divine and fully human. Look upon the human race in your kindness and mercy. We make this in all our prayers through the one who is coming to celebrate and anticipate, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please join us in the song for the foundation of this number 408, O Come, Lord Emmanuel.
Oh,
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice, in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving him thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Thank you.
Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my house, but only say the words, and my soul shall be healed. Christmas Mass will be 7 p.m. Christmas Eve here at St. Joseph's. Visitors are welcome to join us for refreshments in the East Wing after Mass. Having received this pledge of eternal redemption, we pray, Almighty God, that as the feast day of our salvation draws ever nearer, so we may press forward all the more to the worthy celebration of the mystery of your Son's Nativity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth to Mass today.
Please join us in closing song number 407, People Looking.
Yeah.